Pipe loop studies are a very effective way of testing the corrosivity of different plumbing, distribution systems, service line materials in a controlled testing environment.
Pipe loop studies are the most efficient way to determine what will probably happen in your distribution system. Because it's a representation, it's pipes directly from the ground that you took out of your own system. It's a more accurate representation as opposed to other corrosion control methods or studies. You should choose to conduct a pipe loop study if there's a concern about lead in your drinking system, if there will be a concern about lead in your drinking water system, any sort of public health or public initiatives for that. Honestly, any time is a good time to have a pipe loop system.
So a typical pipe loop study starts with conditioning. Conditioning is split into three phases. In the first conditioning phase, water is flushed continuously through the pipe loop. This is to rapidly recondition the test materials to their pre-harvested state. So after about approximately a month of flushing, we'll enter the second conditioning phase. This is where we're gonna start collecting stagnated water samples. We flush the pipe loops for typically 16 hours and then stagnate for 8 hours. So in the second conditioning phase, we start collecting metal samples after an 8-hour stagnation. Once the metal results start to kind of level off, stabilize over time, then we can enter the third conditioning phase. That is where we try to mimic the actual household flow patterns. So typically this is roughly seven and a half hours of stagnation followed by 30 minutes of flow. And this is repeated 3 times a day. And during this phase, we expect the stagnated lead samples to start to spike again because there is much lower water usage than before. After the conditioning phases, we can go into the testing phase. The testing phase uses the same flow pattern as the third conditioning phase, only now we're adding the test water qualities to the pipe loops. When the test materials are harvested, they have a scale that's built up on the interior over many years that contains just different elements that's kind of unique to each distribution system. When they're harvested, these scales tend to dry out. They could become damaged. Several things can happen to them. They basically they get disrupted. And so conditioning them flushes a lot of water they're used to rebuild the scales that were during harvesting.
The water requirement for pipe loop system is pretty intensive. There's water running through that system several times a day for 30 minutes. That water goes directly down into the drain, into the sewer system. So it's finished water that isn't going to a customer.
In terms of time, I would say it takes about 1 hour to sample a single pipe loop. 1 hour per pipe loop. Typically a study uses 3 to 4 pipe loops. The duration of a typical pipe loop study is over a year long. We usually want to allow a few months for conditioning, and then the testing phase, we want to capture at least a year's worth of data in order to capture any seasonal water quality changes and to get there so we can observe their impact on the corrosivity of the distribution system and testing materials. You want to harvest lead pipes because they contain the scale that is built up inside over years, decades, centuries sometimes. That makes the pipe unique to your system.
Whereas new materials, you need to take time to build that scale. They're also a little bit more corrosive, new materials are, because that scale's not there. And it's hard to get an accurate representation using new materials. When you're already taking a lead service line out for a replacement, whether it be a partial replacement, a full replacement, or a water main break, that is a perfect opportunity to go and repurpose that lead service line in these pipe loop studies. It has a scale that will represent your system, and that way you can see what happens when finished water, any changes to that finished water runs through these pipes.
Different materials and replicates are picked based on what the utility has in their system.
So for example, if you have a lot of lead with solder components in your system, then you'll want to use lead with solder in these pipe loops. Whatever you feel like based off of your knowledge of your system is what you should try to replicate or as close to it in these pipe loop systems.
Pipe loop studies should be located in an area of the water treatment plant where you can get a continuous supply of the finished water and any other water that you may test with.
Because it's easy to pump that water through the system itself. That way too, if you have personnel that already has rounds on the floor, they can go and monitor those systems and ensure that nothing is wrong with it. We recommend flow through. Recirculating takes the water that already went through the testing material and recirculates it through, so that water chemistry has changed. And if you're trying to get it back to quote normal, You need a filter or something else to be able to take out the metals that are in the water. Flow through, on the other hand, uses fresh water and mimics more often what's going to happen out on your customer's property.
Even though it does use more water, it delivers better results. It delivers more accurate and reliable results. Data can be collected either by a contractor or an operator. It's a pretty simple process. Anyone can learn how to do it. But what we do is we allow the pipe loops to stagnate for roughly 8 hours before we collect the sample. And then we collect water through through sample taps on the pipe loop. And then we bring that water to a wet lab nearby, where we analyze basic water quality parameters like pH, alkalinity, chlorine, any corrosion inhibitor that you might add. So aside from the basic water quality parameters, we also measure more difficult to measure analytes, such as metals like lead and copper. And these we send to an independent testing lab, and they deliver trustworthy, reliable results. So here is a typical pipe loop skid. Some of the main components include a booster pump, flow meters, flow adjustment valves, chemical injection ports, and the test material. So after the water comes into the pipe loop, it goes through a total flow meter to measure the total flow through the pipe loop, and then passes a chemical injection port where we can inject chemicals, make any adjustments to the water chemistry that we'd like. After that, it is split into its separate replicate legs. After being split into the replicate legs, it goes into an individual flow meter where we can measure the flow and adjust the flow through each individual leg. After that, it flows through the test materials. Here we have lead service lines, but they can be really any lead-containing material that's used in plumbing or distribution systems, such as leaded brass, copper with lead solder. Here it's lead service lines. The methods by which water is conveyed to the pipe loops will vary for every utility based on where the pipe loops are being stored and the water source is being used. Typically, utilities need to pull from their existing finished water and from a point in treatment prior to the addition of a corrosion inhibitor in order to test different treatment techniques without interference from the existing corrosion control practices. When we're sampling the pipe loops, we collect the sample from the sample taps shown here. After the samples are collected, we'll take the samples to a wet lab nearby, run some basic water quality analysis on them, such as measuring pH, alkalinity, chlorine levels. We'll also fill sample containers that we'll send to independent testing labs for more metal analytes, such as lead or other analytes that require more complex analysis.
Some tips to consider is that you can really accurately or precisely know what you're dosing to your pipe loop system if you're doing this for a corrosion control inhibitor. It's pretty easy to do that, which is a nice advantage of having pipe loop systems. And they're super dynamic. You can add a meter, you can cut the pipe and see what happens to lead levels in the system when that happens, almost immediate, what that immediate or long-term effect may be. One advantage of pipe loop systems is the optimization aspect. So you don't want to overdose if you're not seeing any extra benefit. This can be a cost savings for utilities. Pipe loop studies offer that optimization both in terms of cost and what the public health might need or want.